We were asked early in 2017 to develop a programme of activities and events across Dumfries and Galloway that would be delivered by young people, partners and Dumfries and Galloway Council.
So the Year of Young People 2018 was set up by the Scottish Government to celebrate young people's qualities and skills, anyone between the ages of 8 to 25. And it's about recognising them and making sure their voices are heard, whether that's through projects, events, or anything really going on in their community.
Our plan for Year of Young People 2018 here in Dumfries and Galloway has been a huge success. From starting off by our £50,000 participatory budgeting project, which saw local groups being able to apply for money. We saw not only our big events take place, like our LGBT national gathering at Eastwood Hall and hosting the Scottish Youth Parliament sitting in June, we also saw a number of smaller projects take place.
The year was sponsored by a number of funders, which enabled us to provide 8 signature events across 2018 and many grassroots programmes in small communities right across the region.
Over the course of Year of Young People, we have had a variety of different community-based events and grassroots programmes. We also had a variety of summer, Easter and October holiday programmes, through which young people had the opportunity to try out different activities and take part in different opportunities that they might not have had before. One of the really important things that the young people in the project team had come up with was that young people should be recognised and invested in. A really good example of which is the Year of Young People bucket list app. So the project team wanted to make sure that whether they lived in Portpatrick or whether they lived in Tyrfonald, that there was no barrier to taking part or sort of gaining accreditation and recognition of what they've achieved over the course of Year of Young People. So we came up with an app that allowed people to choose and handpick their own challenges, through which they could then gain like a certificate that shows them all the different things they've done over the last year. The feedback from that's been really, really good so far. All of the young people that have taken part have really enjoyed being able to sort of track all the different challenges that they've been doing, and people have really sort of waited and watched out for the new challenges coming out.
Early in 2017, we held a recruitment across the region to recruit young people to the project team. This was a group of young people who were responsible for the co-production across all the events and activities that we've offered this year. And that involved consulting with young folk across Dumfries and Galloway, looking for funding, developing ideas, right through to delivering the events and activities in small communities.
I was able to get involved with the Year of Young People due to the volunteering that I'd previously done with the Oasis Youth Centre and Youth Work Dumfries and Galloway. They provided me this opportunity to host events and do some public speaking, which is something that I first struggled with when I first started attending services here. But now I'm so much more confident and it's given me the opportunity to thrive in this area.
Year of Young Person to me is, I think, very different to what it's billed as or has been kind of seen from a government sense and a kind of national media sense in what you've heard or seen through the year. For me, Year of the Young People has really been about young people engaging with their own youth work services and seeing what's there. For me, I didn't know about Year of the Young People until a couple of months into the year, and actually it was through coming into Year of the Young People I came back into my youth work service and actually have had some incredible opportunities this year that I would never have had if Year of the Young Person hadn't prompted me to get access services again. But being on the upper end of being a young person, it's not who you tend to think are going to necessarily provide opportunities. And to me, little discoveries like that is really what Year of the Young Person is about.
My favourite part of Year of Young People has to be seeing youth beats held at Park Farm. It was absolutely spectacular. The number of hours of volunteering put in by young people and adults, and the excitement around the 2-day event was just amazing to see. The tune performance over 2 days at the Youth Beats Festival, but the 7 days preceding Youth Beats, meant that hundreds of young people learned about social issues in such an interactive way, which has gained national recognition.
The most memorable part to me was doing tune, which was held in Youth Beats. Tune is a drama-based production which faces problems that teens, adults, face on a daily basis, mental health, discrimination, drugs. We done a drug scene which was portrayed by the Charlie and Chocolate Factory scene from Willy Wonka and Violet. And when she was doing the chewing gum, we used that as drugs, and she was taking drugs from someone she didn't know.
I got involved with Young People when it first got mentioned at my school. I was really interested into it, and I came and I did a few meetings, and then I got introduced with the Toon, which I did a scene about transgender rights, and it was amazing. It was amazing to get with everyone and being a team and doing our scenes, and it kept us really busy, and I'm hoping to do it this year as well.
So a lot of my Year of the Young Person involvement this year has been DAV related, just the way it's worked out. So Dumfries and Galloway has also had two of their 8 signature events that have been DAV focused. And the first one was Youth Beats in the summer. Youth Beats this year had a gold residential run in, and I was one of 20 young people who stayed on site for Youth Beats. We were on site for 7 days camping and working on the festival, which was an incredible experience, but already looking forward to next year. Cannot wait to be involved again. It was fantastic and will be a Year of the Young Person highlight for me for years to come. So my favourite event, I think, has to be the first one I was involved in. Around February time, I got a message from one of the youth workers that I'd worked with a lot before I went off to uni and moved away to say that Roots was happening. So it was an event all about youth democracy. So Roots was really, really interesting from the off for me, but I didn't think at first I was going to go, but I actually ended up going, and I'm so glad I did, because I think I'd forgotten, in just moving on and finding different interests, how much I actually enjoyed the youth democracy stuff I'd done in the past. That really opened my eyes to the power of my voice and the power of my voice as a young person, and actually showed me that from my past and through skills we developed on the day, I kind of did have the confidence and the skill set to push forward on things I'd thought about doing, but was kind of a little nervous to do, which wouldn't have happened if I hadn't been at Roots and we discovered that kind of passion that I had forgotten.
My favourite parts of the year have to be the LGBT National Youth Gathering, which I was able to host. It was amazing to see so many enthusiastic young people be themselves and be able to openly talk and discuss issues that they face maybe in their local communities.
My favourite event was LGBT National Gathering, because it was amazing seeing everyone just being themselves, and it was especially good that it was in Dumfries, because it's normally different places in Scotland, it's really hard for people in the region to get there and stuff, so it was amazing seeing everyone come together and just being themselves, and it's good.
My favourite part of the year so far has been the Moving Forward Together conference that was delivered a few weeks ago. The event was organised, planned and run fully by young people. It was their ideas, it was their suggestions, their programme, and they were there in the day and they hosted it and they did a brilliant job. And it was really nice to see how much they'd grown over the year, how much they'd learned for delivering loads of different events, and they absolutely nailed it.
My favourite bit of the Year of Young People has been seeing how young people grow and develop in confidence and their skills, and more importantly, seeing them challenging the decision makers, those people who make decisions on young people's lives every day.
Due to the fact that there's been massive amounts of effort and hard work put into creating every single one of the events, it's not just been volunteers either, the amount of work that youth workers have put into it, as well as volunteers, has been truly amazing.
Roots, which was kind of the highlight of Year of Young People for me, in terms of how it's affected me personally. Without Roots, there's a whole bunch of activism and conversations that I would never have taken part in. So since Roots, I've met with national youth strategy leads, I've challenged Young Scot around content and then helped them build new content, I've met with government ministers, I've brought national charities work into the ENG. So none of that would have came without the Year of the Young People intros, without organisations that have done kind of specialised events that have led to training days, or have led to activism days, or have led to kind of networking. It's all been youth focused, but without Roots and without the kind of real moment of this is what I enjoy, this is what I want to do, you know, I have things that I want to change and a voice that I want to share, I wouldn't have shared as much as I have done, and I definitely think my voice would not have been heard without the support of D&G Youth Work and their incredible staff.